Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to understand Tesca's high voltage power electronics lab. With this equipment, here we can understand the various applications of power diode, power SCR and power IGBT with different combinations of loads which are provided with this kit. The equipment works on the high voltage power supply, which is 440 volt 3-phase supply. In this, there are different types of power supply provided. This is the single phase power supply. The MCB is there to power on this section. Now then for single phase low voltage power supply, there are also a separate switch to power on this supply. Then 3-phase power supply with RYB connections. There is 3-phase 3-pole MCB to provided to power on this section, and 3-phase low voltage power supply. In this, RYB terminals in two sections provided. Also there is a MCB to power on this section. Further, there is diode assembly. In this, 6 diodes are placed which can use in experiment. Then this is the SCR assembly. In this, 6 SCRs are placed with combinations of different experiments. And then this is the IGBT assembly. In this, 6 IGBTs provided as well. Now for firing circuit modules, there is 3-phase firing circuit. The circuit is drawn on this section. Then PWM circuit for PWM pulses. Then RAM comparator firing circuit for different types of RAM firing sections. Then cycloconverter firing circuit for AC supply. There are the circuit modules which are made on the experiment. Then in measurement section, there is power scope and oscilloscope. The power scope is used to high voltage power supply. Then there is voltage and current measurement section. In this, there is DC voltmeter, DC ammeter, AC voltmeter and AC ammeter. Also there is supplied the load assembly. Through this, various type of loads will be connected. This is the lamp load assembly, in which 4 holders, bulb holders are provided, and 4 bulbs of 200 volts also provided. This is a 1x8 HP motor, and this is the heater load. These are the various load sections which is used to perform different type of experiments with this assembly and power circuit modules. This is a ready to use BNC type cable which prevents the excess time or excess patch cost to use, which can be connected from here to here, this port directly any of the firing circuit. These are the different types of patch cord which are used to perform the experiment. Now we are going to perform experiment through this lab. The equipment works on the 3-phase input socket, input supply. This is the input socket of 3-phase. This is the MCB to power on this circuit, and there is a fan, exhaust fan, for cooling the system. So now we power on this supply, and we can see the 3-phase indication here, RYB, which indicates the system is on to perform any experiment. But always make sure the safety measures, because this is the 3-phase power supply circuit which can be harmful for any unexperienced. So first we are going to perform single phase half wave uncontrolled rectifier with lamp load. In this section, we are using diode. The power supply is connected to diode and on terminals to the load. The power scope also connected across the load, and there is a lamp load which is connected through the load assembly. Also we have connected the DC voltmeter to measure the voltmeter voltage across the lamp load. Also we will connect the power scope through BNC to BNC cable to oscilloscope. Now as we have power on the supply, This is the single phase supply we are going to power on. Now you can see the voltage here 110 volt and the waveform across the half of the halfway control uncontrolled rectifier through this diode assembly, and the load is working at the 110 voltage through power scope, the BNC to BNC. In the oscilloscope we can observe the waveform. This is the half wave uncontrolled rectifier. Now we have connected the motor load to this section. The rest of the connections are same. So we power on this supply and we can see the motor is running at the 121 DC voltage. You can see the waveform at the oscilloscope as well. So this is the uncontrolled half wave rectifier. Now for experiment number 2, we are going to perform half wave control rectifier with lamp load. In this section we are using RAM comparator firing circuit and an SCR. The RAM comparator firing circuit is used to firing the SCR. From RAM comparator circuit, the gate pulses are given to SCR and the SCR perform the working. In this, the line terminal of single phase power supply is connected to anode of SCR and the neutral terminal is connected to other end of load, and one end of load is connected to cathode of SCR. Rest of the connection of power scope and digital voltmeter is same. We have connected 18 voltage AC, low voltage AC supply to the RAM comparator circuit and 12 volt plus minus DC supply also through this BNC cable to the RAM comparator circuit for the power on of RAM comparator. So we first power on the RAM comparator circuit, then we power on the single phase supply. We can see the bulb load is on it very dim voltage, which is shown at voltmeter. This is 11 volt. As we vary the firing angle, the bulb start glowing brighter and the voltage are increasing across the load, and you can see the waveform also varies as the firing angle varies. This is the full capacity of half wave control rectifier. As we vary the firing angle to lower, the waveform also goes lower, voltage goes lower and brightness of bulbs also goes lower. So this is the half wave control rectifier through the SCR and the RAM comparator circuit. So now we are going to understand the PWM firing circuit. In this circuit we connected plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt and ground through this BNC cable to single phase low voltage power supply. The section is power on and the circuit is also given to power. Now we test the PWM pulses through this BNC to test probe. The test probe is connected to channel 1 of the oscilloscope. Now first we observe the square wave generators output. The ground terminal is connected to point 2 and the test terminal is connected to point 1. Square wave generators output at the oscilloscope. Now we further see the output of integrator circuit. For this we connected the ground pin to ground and test pin to point number 3. You can see in the oscilloscope the waveform of as triangular. This is the output of integrator circuit. Now we observe the PWM pulse once output after the comparator circuit. For this, we connect the ground pin to the ground terminal and the test pin to the PWM 1 pulse terminal. Observing the output of comparator circuit as PWM pulse, we connect the ground terminal of test probe to ground and the positive terminal to PWM pulse 1. You can see in the oscilloscope the PWM pulses are shown. We can vary the PWM pulse with this potentiometer of PWM 1. The pulse is the minimum here. There is the maximum pulses. We can also vary the frequency with this frequency potentiometer provided at PWM circuit. With this, we can vary the frequency of pulses, which is around 250 Hz minimum from around 5 kHz maximum. So this is the PWM circuit, which is used to understand the PWM pulses. Now for next experiment, we are going to study the single phase cycloconverter with lamp load. For this, we are using cycloconverter firing circuit and 4 SCR modules from this SCR assembly. Now for powering on the firing circuit of cycloconverter, we first connect this PNC type probe to 18 volt power supply and +12 to -12 DC volt power supply. This cycloconverter firing circuit. Here we can see the firing circuit is power on. Now we will make the further connections for the cycloconverter circuit. So now we have made up the connection as per the procedure, explained in the experiment. We have connected 4 SCR through the patch cords and we have provided gate pulses to SCR through the cycloconverter circuit. Now we power on the circuit and also single phase low voltage power supply. You can see the light bulb is glowing at the 63 or 65 voltage AC and the waveform of the load output is shown at the oscilloscope. As we vary the firing angle, the intensity varies and the voltage also varies with the firing angle. And you can see the waveform goes minimum and again as we increase the firing angle, the intensity of pulse increases to its maximum as the waveform. So this is the cycloconverter firing circuit using 4 SCR bridge we have performed here with the lamp load. In this experiment, we are going to study 3 phase half wave control rectifier with lamp load. For this, we are using 3 phase firing circuit. The connections has been made as per the manual procedure. This is the single phase low voltage 12 volt 5 volt supply to provide it to the 3 phase firing circuit. This is the low voltage 3 phase supply which is provided through this cable. We are using here SCR 1, 2 and 3 in the common cathode configuration, and we are using lamp as the load, and power scope and DC voltmeter is also connected across the load. So as we power on the supply, 3 phase low voltage power supply and 3 phase. Now you can see the bulb is glowing at the 189 DC volt, and the waveform of output is shown here. This is the 3 phase half wave control rectifier. Now as we vary the firing angle, the voltage goes to low, as well as the intensity of bulb also goes low, and the waveform has shown the output. This is the minimum and this is the maximum intensity, around 230 volt for this bulb, and the waveform output you can see at the oscilloscope. So this is the half wave control rectifier with this 3 phase circuit. So all the description about the firing circuits are provided in manual, and you can do experiment with different combinations of load and different firing circuits through this high voltage power electronics lab. Thank you from Tesla.